Hello, everybody. It's the coach welcoming you to Madden Ultimate Team. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Straight ahead, we've got what should be an interesting matchup between the Los Angeles Rams and the San Francisco 49ers. With that, let's get you out to Silicon Valley, Levi Stadium in Santa Clara, as we welcome in our broadcast team, Brandon Gunn and Charles Davis.
And hi again, everybody. Alongside my partner, Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gaughton. And Charles, when you and I were going through our final run-throughs at breakfast, we kept thinking, tonight we're going to get to see a couple of very good passing offenses.
And we're talking about both sides having multiple receivers that could have an impact on this game. It's not just one guy that's going to make all the plays. If you take him away, maybe number two, number three, they make the big plays that impact who wins the game.
And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. So that one, a 13-play drive in total. And it winds up with a touchdown for Los Angeles. Lutz now to kick this one away. This will be fielded at the 8. That'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Francisco gets set to go here. A little less than 4 minutes remaining, and the margin for error is small with this slim lead.
Operating in your 4 minute offense here, Charles? Definitely. Remember, the 4 minute offense doesn't always correspond to what's up on the clock. What they need to do is spend a little bit of keep away right now. Run the clock down. Make sure they're going to go.
Got to him. He takes him down for a loss of 9. And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19. Garoppolo now. And he's taken down. Back at his own 7. Joey Bosa in there to drop him for the second straight play. They may want to block him on third down.
Okay, let's go back a little bit and see if my schooling comes to the front. What's that old saying? Those who forget the lessons of history are doomed to repeat them. That's the same guy who's gotten back-to-back sacks. I think a double team may be in order.
A dump down to McKinnon. And they're able to bring him down at the 20. It's a gain of 11, but they're still well short. It's fourth down. And his defense here going to earn their second timeout. And you can also factor in another timeout that they'll get when the clock stops at the 2 minute warning. The defense, they got a little bit of a breather. Now they're back and set as we resume play. Here's Bradley Pinion now, as he's on to punt for the first time tonight. With it is Brown. Good blocking there, nearly sprung him as it is. This ball is a 19-yard return. Here with a first and 10. The Rams offense now making their way out to take over. They were forced to punt last time, and I doubt sincerely that they'll have to punt here because they're gifted with terrific field position.
I don't even want to think about the idea that they would end up punting starting with this type of field position. Neither do that.
It's caught inside the 25. That goes for a gain of 31. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. So it's Rams football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over.
And they didn't get it done,
and now you look at the situation and the point differential, two scores, pretty much game set back.
How about the takeaway, though, huh? How about those defensive guys?
Now the Rams offense, they work their way back on the field. Two timeouts remaining defensively, but that shouldn't make much difference right here.
It really shouldn't, but a lot of coaches look at it similar to baseball with the intention of what?
Always bringing in other scores.
Oh, is it?
And he's going to take this one away for the Rams touchdown. Randy Moss, the second touchdown of the night, and the Rams add on to their lead.
I've got a laugh here, and I really don't want to because the old school in me is not happy about this score this late, not necessary. But this is Madden, isn't it?
Yeah.
This is how it works.
Rub it in. Have a day.
I mean, what does it matter? These guys who are playing in this game, there are no feelings there.
Exactly. They don't have to face the guy. Well, they might if they're in the same room.
But the virtual
guys on the screen don't have to face each other after this one.
In that case, run it up.
What's good on the extra point? And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. This is fielded with a chalk of the 10. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Here's Garoppolo on first and 10. Now the incomplete with 9 seconds now showing on the clock. He was trying to get it to Jerick McKinnon there. And now it's second down.
Sometimes the coverage is so good, no matter what you're doing on offense, you just can't shake anyone free. They try their best to find someone open. They took away every passing alley, every angle, and shut the play down.
And now with 4 seconds left, we get a timeout call. Garoppolo now, perfect since the second half started. 7-7. It's first and 10. One final try now for Garoppolo. He's going to run it far. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Dominique Rodgers-Grimaldi. Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. What are they thinking on offense?
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game. They put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can follow this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you still think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
Thank you.
Yeah.